Welcome back to the 29th Atlantic Film Festival opening night gala here at the Metro Center. The place is hopping, the drinks are pouring, and things are underway here, aren't they, Matt?
Oh, yeah, the trailer park boys have just arrived here, so you can imagine us going to ratchet the party up just a little bit and check in with things down on the floor. Let's go back down to Scott.
Seen it.
Well, I tell you what, you caught me kind of off guard or having a chat with one of the trailer park girls. Hi.
How did that happen? That is so random.
I don't even know. I mean, we were just kind of hanging out and chatting off on the side.
You were helping me adjust my...
I was.
Okay, why don't we just get rid of that?
Yeah, just here, pull it here. I'll put that in my pocket. Perfect.
You can sell that on eBay for like $4.50.
$4.50? Hello.
$4.50.
Yeah. So listen, tell me about the big night tonight. What was going on at the Oxford?
Well, tonight at the Oxford, it was the world premiere of Countdown to Liquor Day, the second Trailer Park Boys film that we shot for reals, the first film that we ever shot, was premiered 10 years ago at this film festival. So it's just a nice way to wrap up a decade of entertaining a nation.
You said just before we got surprised by our camera and interrupted our conversation that actually tonight was the first time that you got to see the completed film. What was it like watching it for the first time?
You know, for me, it was really nice to watch it because this was a film that Mike Clattenburg got to make sort of unadorned. He didn't have to worry about... We knew it was the last thing. He didn't have to worry about an external body coming in. Like, he didn't have to sort of concern about Hollywood wanting to make an impression or making an impression on a future television base. But it was his project. It was very much what his vision. And so it was nice to see that. He made a film that was, I think, warmer than the last one. And it felt like a tribute to specifically the character of Mr. Leahy.
And I think it was interesting, too. He was quoted in the paper as saying that the first film, like you said, maybe a little darker, maybe a little more away from the original concept. But this movie, he said that there wasn't a shot that maybe a documentary film crew couldn't have taken as well. So kind of going back to the roots.
Yeah, going back to the roots and also hitting the theme of the show. No matter what kind of success you have, even if you're living in paradise, if you're sunburned, alone, and drunk, and you don't have anyone to share that with, then what's the point? Where's the celebration?
Well, we're so glad that you stopped by. Congratulations and best of luck and have a good time tonight.
Thanks. I'm going to party with Miss Canada. Hello.
Thanks for dropping by. Let's go back upstairs.
Welcome back to the Atlantic Film Festival. Kind of threw me off guard there, Scott, talking to the very, very, very well-known Lucy DeCouture of the Trailer Park Boys. Here she does a great job in that film, and she's always put entertaining.
That's right, Lise, and as Lucy just mentioned there, this is sort of wrapping up the Trailer Park Boys. It's been 10 years, and you can really sense talking to the boys today, and you can just hear Lucy saying that this movie, I think, really embodies what the Trailer Park Boys is all around. You know, it was big news when Ivan Reitman came to town and made the first Trailer Park Boys movie, but I think hardcore fans thought it was kind of watered down. They were sort of trying to do a movie for everybody, so I think they're really happy with the way this movie turned out. Speaking of the Trailer Park Boys, I'm hoping Scott has another guest from the movie. Scott?
Welcome back to Eastlink All Access Pass Opening Night Gala for the 29th Atlantic Film Festival. The party keeps going here, and I've got another guest joining me on the red carpet, a gentleman that actually has two personalities, John Dunsworth and, of course, Jim Leahy. Mr. Leahy, big night for you. How did you enjoy yourself at the Oxford Theater?
It was kind of anticlimactic.
Now, I was talking to the boys earlier, and they were telling me that they might have a few plans tonight to take a couple of things out of the Metro Center here. Anything you can do to maybe intervene?
Well, you know, Ricky, Julie, and Bubbles have got to be given enough rope so that they hang themselves. Because there's no way you can stop a shitstorm. I just want you to know.
Are you willing to provide the rope?
No, the thing is that I'm finished with those guys. I'm moving on. Randy and I are doing a 360-degree world tour. We are. We're going to Leicester Square in England. We do bar mitzvahs. We do memory examinations. We do probes. We do everything because we are general factotums.
Well, I guess the nice thing is about one of the exams, you could say thanks for the memories.
Yeah, it's true. But we are going to Australia. I'm outfitting a boat right now, and we're going to row across. We're going to have the world press with us, bud. We're going to be playing Leicester Square in England.
Well, listen, John, we're going to talk to you now, John. Only a couple of seconds left, but what has this ride been like?
It's been 10 years of wonderment. I've been an actor for 40 years, and actually I'm going back on the stage in Neptune in October, November. But this has been working with Mike Lattenberg, Mike Smith, JP, and Rick, and Pat, and everybody. It's and traveling around Canada and meeting all the fans, it's a dream come true.
Well, listen, we appreciate you doing this so much, and best of luck tonight and have fun, okay?
Thank you very much.
Pleasure, all right.
Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot. Jim, John, he goes by both, and he's happy with both. Let's go back upstairs. All right, well, I tell you what, the gentlemen of the hour are here right now. The Trailer Park Boys themselves, Julian, Bubbles, and, of course, Ricky. Julian, let's first start off with you. Big night tonight. How are you?
Pretty good. I need a few drinks. I mean, I wasn't drinking much during the show, so, you know, I'm going to catch up here, have a couple drinks. That'll be happy.
The nice thing about the Eastlink TV crew is that we've got maps drawn to all the bars around the Metro Center, so we can hook you up.
Nice, man. Well, you should have, like, a little cooler here. You know, some mix, some ice.
See, we should have had a cooler. Bullseye, Paul. Drum it out, buddy. Drum it out. You having fun?
I'm having a great time. How about you?
Well, I tell you what, it's been a lot better in the last 30 seconds since you guys dropped by. What's been the best part so far tonight?
Oh, I mean, the liquor, the popcorn, the movie, the ladies. It's just been a great night.
Now, I'm surprised that you listed the ladies on the back of that list. Why wouldn't they be first?
Let's go from bottom to top, so ladies were actually number one.
So really, it's reverse thinking.
Yes, reverse thinking.
Now, let me ask you, Ricky, best part of the night for you so far, and what are you looking forward to?
A fan gave me about 25 joints pre-roll. That was probably the best part, but I'm looking forward to liquor and, yeah, partying, I guess, and ladies as well.
Would you say that's one of the best parts of having the recognition that you have is fans giving you pre-roll?
It's not a bad thing.
Yeah.
Free cigarettes? Yeah. So there's some good parts.
Now, when you guys first rolled up, I mentioned to Julian here about my enjoyment of the rum and coke, and I couldn't even come near him to pry on none of his fingers. Is that normal?
He's pretty protected.
Don't try to get at that. He'll snap at you.
Any chance at all I might be able to...
No.
No?
No.
Well, before we send you inside, what can the fans expect from you guys tonight now? Is there going to be any kind of scheming going on? Are you going to try and maybe get some of the lighting fixtures and try and maybe, you know, work a little deal?
Oh, we're going to steal a few things in here, definitely. Other than that, I don't know. We're just going to drink a lot of booze and go with it.
Sounds like a plan, guys. Drink a lot of booze and go with it. What do you guys think?
100%. Let's get her going.
Yeah.
It's console time.
Hopefully go to sleep in the drunk tank tonight. It's going to be a good one.
Boys, I got to thank you, Ricky. Bubbles. Beautiful time. Have a lot of fun. There it is. Trailer Park Boys living large. And remember, it's about pre-roll, the drinks, and of course, from the bottom up, it's about the ladies. Let's go back upstairs.